alternative to MagMath, Maple, Mathematica, and MATLAB. Sometimes you say these are the four M's of commercial mathematics software. Started in 2005 by William Stein. He's now a professor in mathematics at University of Washington. He was doing stuff in Magma and got fed up with closed source software that he couldn't collaborate with very well and share with other people, et cetera. And so he started Sage. Initially, very heavy emphasis in number theory. There's quite a few packages and things like that that are about academic mathematics, but all sorts of mathematics these days are included in Sage. GPL version 3, one of the philosophies in Sage is to, instead of reinventing the wheel, to build the car. It means, in simple, about 100 or so top quality open source implementations of different types of programs and glue them all together with Python. Put a very small preparser layer on top of that to make the mathematics notation a little bit nicer to enter. And then also, so we have packages like R and NumPy and SciPy and some mathematics packages like Gap and Singular and about 100 other packages. And then about 450,000 lines of our own code that's a mathematical library built on category theory and advanced mathematics and tons of research mathematics code in there, tons of code that's useful at an undergraduate level as well, or in industry, 2D, 3D graphics, lots of documentation and lots of top tests. Sage is pretty vibrant. We have a release about one or two or three months apart, with about every release has about 100 contributors. Usually about 10% of those contributors are first time contributing to Sage, so it's not only a vibrant community, but a pretty growing community. It's cross-platform. We've got releases on Mac and Linux, and then a VM-based Windows release, so it's a Linux VM that you can run on Windows. And there's lots of fruits that you see from Sage. How many people have heard of Cython? So that came out of the Sage project. We realized Python was too slow, so William Stein and Robert Bradshaw and Craig Citro and some other people forked Pyrex and became Cython, and then was spun off out of the Sage project as an independent Cython project. For years, since 2007-ish, 2008-ish, we've had a pretty successful web notebook, hundreds of thousands of users. We had an interactive widget implementation. Both of these served as inspiration for the IPython notebook and IPython widget implementation. There's been tons of people doing interactive textbooks. A lot of activity in the academic, mathematics and academic world. And many, many other fruits from Sage. So without further ado, we've had a web notebook for a long time with hundreds and hundreds of thousands of users. A couple of years ago, William sat back and decided to rewrite the whole thing and reimagine sort of what it was going to look like. And so he figuratively just locked himself in his basement and started coding for 2 years. This guy's a machine. What the result is what we have, cloud.sagemath.com. So this is an open source software. The source is up on GitHub. And it's GPL, and a major implementation of it is running on his servers. So let's go to SageMath Cloud. When you log into SageMath Cloud, you are presented with a number of projects. So the basic unit of things is a project, and a project you can think of as a directory of a bunch of stuff. Projects can be shared, things can be collaborative. So here we have a bunch of different projects you can see. And the people that are shared with these projects. Okay, so going into a project, we have a number of different types of files. So here's a Sage notebook, for example. So you click on a file and it opens up a tab here. Here's a Sage notebook. It gives you a little flavor for what Sage can do here. So, yes, still is true. 1 + 1 = 2. Can you see this? I'm always relieved that Sage keeps answering that. We can do harder things. So factor, you'll notice here, we have a thin veneer on top of Python. This is all Python syntax, except we've added a few things, like the caret is an exponentiation operator. There's a few little tiny things like that to make a mathematics notation a little bit easier. So here's factoring. If we want to see things a little bit nicer, we can do in typeset mode. So this turns on typeset mode for the thing, and now we use math tracks in order to display the factored. We've got 2D graphics, of course, plot x squared, and 3D graphics. So here's a nice 3D graphic, and 3D around. that. So there's tons and tons of research code in Sage. The combinatorics community in particular has really taken off and contributed hundreds of thousands of lines probably of code to Sage. Here's an example of a binary tree, and there's tons of research code dealing with discrete mathematics and combinatorics. We have an interactive widget implementation that's been around for a long time. So here's sort of like the IPython widgets. You drag the slider and refactoring. So all you do is you decorate a function, f of x. Here's, it knows to take this input and that shortcut code for a slider. And then every time the slider value is changed, it runs the function and prints out the factorial. Or we can do something a little bit more advanced. Here's an example that we've used in undergraduate mathematics, just calculating the Taylor series, Taylor polynomial, for u to the negative x of x. We don't have just code cells, we also have things like markdown cells. So you notice the idea behind the Sage notebook here is that we have a bunch of cells, and if you want to change the type of cell, all you do is you put, for example, this %MD up at the top. And what this does is it just calls the MD function with the rest of the cell as text. And that function takes care of rendering the markdown and then hiding the source, so you can annotate things. One of the things Sage is really emphasizes collaborating with other systems, so it includes R. And an interface to R, so here's an R histogram that apparently it worked the other day, or the other a little while ago. Okay, we'll pretend you see a histogram at work. I'm not sure. I probably reassigned the variable R here. Let's restart. Ah, there we are. There's the histogram for R. Julia includes an interface to Julia. So here's finding the eigenvalues and eigenvectors of the random matrix in Julia. So you can work with lots of systems back and forth. One of the other things about this notebook is different than the IPython notebook is the entire notebook is inside of a single editor. So it's very, very, very easy to highlight a bunch of code or move up and down because basically the entire thing is in one single editor. You're not dealing with discrete cells here. One of the things that's emphasized in Sage is in the Sage Math Cloud is collaborative editing. Let's see, Sylvan, are you around?
Yeah.
So here we have a 3D vector field here, and Sylvan, could you just change that to be whatever function you want? Let's see, are you in here? Oh, do you see it? There he is, Sylvan Corlay. So what Sylvan's, I've shared this project with Sylvan, and we're doing real-time 3D, collaboration, Google Docs style editing of this notebook here. So he's changed the function, and he's reevaluating, and we're both collaborating with this document. Here's a 3D vector field.
Yeah.
Pretty awesome. And if that's not enough, then, I mean, we could just chat with each other here. Hey. Stop that. We were joking about how much you could do with my talk here. But if that's not enough, we could just really chat here. Let's see if this works here.
I see you.
Oh, you see me, And well, if you could see Sylvan's thing, you would see that we're video chatting, so there's a video chat as well. Apparently, there we are. So there's Sylvan. Hi, Sylvan. So this is incredibly useful when you're trying to debug somebody's problem. Every file can have a chat associated with it and a video chat associated with it. And it's real live video chats here. All right, so that's just the Sage files. It's not just Sage files that you can use the Sage Math Cloud for. You can also use IPython notebooks. So William integrated the IPython notebook with this, so this is a real live IPython notebook, but it has two really nice additions. One, we have real-time collaboration. This is an underlying principle of the entire system, is real-time collaboration. Oh, there's Sylvan again. So this isn't in the IPython notebook. We're actually working on it for the IPython notebook, but William already has it in the Sage Math Cloud here. And second, we have this publish button. So what this does is, It converts your notebook to an HTML file, publishes it out for anybody to see. So these files, you just give somebody this link right here, and they'll be able to see the published version of your notebook. So good integration with the IPython notebook. But not just IPython notebooks and Sage notebooks, we also have complete file editing here. So this is a Python file. It's actually the IPython widget source code. And again, complete collaborative editing. Let me tell you, one time some students and I were working on a Python file, and we were all working together. Of course, we all had our laptops out. We were all working on the same file because our project was up in the SageMath.io. And we sat down and we planned out what we were going to do in the next 30 minutes. And so you do this function, you do this function. Let's see, your function is going to call this function, and then I'll do this function. OK, ready, go. Five cursors, scatter across the code, start writing in real time and everything. 20 minutes later, regroup, press run, works perfectly. It was like an orchestra doing a symphony. It almost brought tears to my eyes. but my colleagues have also used it in classes, for example. 30 students are all editing the same file. Hey, can you fix that error? Okay, now what are you going to do with that? And it's amazing the things you can do once you have collaborative editing in the mix when you're writing code. So not just Python files, but tech files. So William wrote a side-by-side tech renderer. So this is a tech file. People know what tech is. Okay, good. So it's the standard for mathematical publishing and mathematical writing. And we actually add some things. This has been a feature of Sage for a long time. You ever write a tech file and you have to do some calculation and then you have to copy and paste or rewrite by hand the results of the calculation? It's terrible if you're writing tests. I'm speaking as a university professor here. So Sage has this Sage tech package that was worked on by several members of the Sage community. And what it lets you do is do actual Sage computations in the notebook or in the tech file. So the number 2015 factors as you write this in your tech file. That shows up in your PDF. Isn't that awesome? You want to generate a plot? This is terrible. You always have to go back and generate a plot, save it to disk, remember what file name it is, include the graphics, etc. Much easier to just have Sage generate the plot. You write this tech code. You tech it. What it does is it pulls out the Sage code, runs Sage on it, gets the result, and you can select it back into your PDF document, and this is the result. You've got the plot. All sorts of things from 2D vector fields, all of this. So William implemented a reverse search. I double click on the PDF file and it pulls up the line in the tech file. And so all I have is Sage getting this function. Sage computes the gradient and plots it. Everything from 3D plots. Easiest way to put 3D plots in a tech file that I know of. Here it is. Have Sage draw the 3D plot, slam it in. Check it, and it's done. It's in the file. You can even have Sage, so here's a Cayley graph, a mathematical object. Sage can generate really nice graphics and can send them right into tech files. You can even have Sage be a nice tech scripting language. So here, I'm using Python to write my tech for me, and then the result is just put in my tech file, and I didn't have to write out this laborious big tech people. So there's tons of cool things you can do with Sage. Sage Math Cloud makes it really nice. Of course, it's all collaborative. I've helped students quite a bit with tech presentations and things like that. Just collaborative editing. For the power users, you can use actually a terminal. So this is the full terminal. Come up in just a second. Let me refresh here. So this was a full terminal. You get full terminal access. You can do anything you want from the command line. In fact, it's collaborative as well. Anybody sharing the document can see everything you do. I'm not sure why it's not pulling up. You can run VI, Emacs, etc. For the even more power users, you can SSH into your projects. You click on the settings over here, and all you need to do for your you click on the project settings. And it gives you an address that you can SSH in. There we are. If you want to SSH into your project, you can SSH right in and do as much command line food as you want to do. Git you to realize you can pretty much live your life in SageMath cloud. So you want to have some assurances of stability. And so, of course, there's snapshots every couple of days. Never lose any work. You have snapshots taken every 2 or 3 minutes or so. And you can browse back through your history any time you like. And you know, the power that the SageMath cloud has brought to the online mathematical computing world is amazing. And as one more thing, this is a project that's very live, very, very vibrant. Just the other day, like yesterday or the day before yesterday, William posted a link to a virtual machine. You're welcome to run SageMath. It's free open source software. And here's a VM that has everything set up so that you can run it on your own computer. You don't need to use the SageMath cloud project. So you'll notice this is an address that's local to my computer. This is an implementation of SageMath cloud running on my computer. And it's just about ready to release a complete big rewrite of the SageMath cloud, and also to release this a single user version